I'm sharing with you today a CHA sneak peek on how I created the sofa table, and you're gonna see that coming up at the end, but I wanted to give you a little bit behind the scenes and to show you how easy it is to make your own cube sofa table. It is so, so cute. This is a great way to store your craft supplies, create a really cool bookshelf. I love working with crates and cubicles because you can group everything together in its own category. And I bought 6 crates. Actually, I bought 35. But for this project, I'm using 6 crates. And one of my recent videos, I showed you just how we painted and we antiqued them. And now I'm ready to put on the top. I purchased an 8-foot 1x12. And because I'm gonna do other projects with this, it was cheaper in the long run to purchase the whole 8-foot. And I had him cut the length there. That way I didn't have to worry about using a table saw. So if you don't have a table saw, you don't have to worry. I have measured my 3 crates and I have cut the length of my board to 40 inches. I also bought a furring strip. Now these come 8-foot long. They're about 2 inches wide and about 1 inch thick. So technically they're 2 inches by 1 inch, but really they're about 1¾ inches by about 3/4. So make sure that you buy wood according to the actual size of the wood. Just because it says it's 10 inches, it's not really, it's 9¼ or 2 inches, 1¾ inches. But I have also cut this piece of wood 40 inches long, the same length as my tabletop here. I've mitered the corners, see? These nice little miters right here. You're on a diagonal. Now, your 40 inches needs to be from this longest part of the diagonal to the longest part of the diagonal. Don't cut it to the short end because then your board will be too short. I also have 2 pieces, 10 inches, that I have cut. These are for the sides, and I've mitered each of the ends. Just one end. Don't need to miter the other end because the back isn't gonna show. I've lined my mitered, the bottom of my mitered corner to the end of the board here, and I've sunk a little nail here just to kind of keep it straight. But I'm going to make this extra secure by adding a little bit of liquid nails wood glue. So to finish out my tabletop, I added a little bit of wood stain in my favorite color, American Walnut, and I love how that gave it a nice contrast. It sure was the hit of the show. Well, please take a moment to click that subscribe button. It's right up there in the corner because I'm always sharing new tips and new techniques and tutorials and jewelry making videos and DIY and how-to and cooking and who knows what all I'm going to share, but I don't want you to miss it, and be sure to give me the thumbs up. I'm Linda Peterson. Thanks for joining me in the studio today, and keep living a creative life.